That's true. That's a fancy one.
Just saying.
Hey, you guys, you're listening to New Kids on the Block. You know they're from Boston.
That's right.
Oh,
yeah,
look at that.
Dorchester. Oh. Yeah.
Sometimes it works out.
He picked that.
He absolutely did that on purpose.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. All right, you guys have a great day.
You too.
Yep.
Happy Monday.
And we'll keep it going right here for you on America's Morning Headquarters, getting you through the mid-morning hours, helping you plan for everything ahead this week.
Yeah, lots to go for us as we kick things off. Hopefully you had a good Easter weekend. Now we're kicking things off on this Monday behind us. Things are getting going here at the Boston Marathon. We're actually going to get a chance to talk to Justin Michaels, who is there live, give us an update here on this this race that'll be happening here. In fact, I think they're going to be going pretty soon.
5 minutes, maybe like 5.5 minutes, they start the wheelchair races, and then we go from there. And at 10 o'clock is when the mass start begins, and we'll keep it going through the day today. It's a beautiful-looking day.
Gosh,
we'll have to talk to Justin about how it feels.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, yeah, we've got that. How about the weather situation out there for us with the snapshot?
I mean, it's so different across the country.
It really is. My.
Mm. All right. Do you run, Alex?
I have.
We're planning something for the summer. Meanwhile, we want you to lace up your shoes, get ready to run from the rain. These kind of conditions. I mean, you could see those flakes flying. Now, here's a look where it is snowing. Duluth, Minneapolis, east side of town especially. Some flakes are flying around here, especially up towards Duluth and just south. You see this darker blue, some enhancement on the radar. That's where it's falling and sticking. Flying around the skies, too, around Green Bay today. Parts of Michigan, Grand Rapids. You've got some snow showers out there. Let's look at the numbers, because is it going to stick? Well, on the grass. I mean, look, the April sun angle is really good. We used to say this about the March sun angle, right? So that'll help you on the roads. But temps are down to 31 in Duluth and into Minneapolis. So maybe on your rooftops, you're getting a coating of snow there. Kalamazoo, Grand Rapids, 32, 33. So same kind of situation. The roads are probably fine. But when the snow falls heavy enough, you know, even if the temperature is above freezing, it can accumulate, because certainly snow is ice. It's cold, right? And so it can refrigerate the surfaces. Now, here's a look at how we play out today. A couple of flakes flying around across Wisconsin. It's really, I think, lower Michigan that really gets into a lot of the action. Detroit, yes, 38 degrees, but we still could see some snow, and we'll see that swinging down into parts of Ohio as well. This is all through the early afternoon, evening hours. You can see how we're still holding on to it into the evening and overnight. We don't really kick it out until tomorrow here across Michigan. So about 1 to 3 inches, northern parts of lower Michigan, like around Alpena. Detroit, maybe we get a coating of snow. Up farther north, though, up here in the thumb of Michigan, right in here, we're going to see anywhere from 2 to 3 inches of snowfall. And down towards Cleveland, yes, we could pick up an inch or two of snow. Let's look at those temperatures, because you know, to get snow to stick, it's got to be chilly, right? Tomorrow morning, we're going to be in the 20s, Minneapolis, 26 degrees. By the way, International Falls yesterday was 11. It was a record low. Oh, your Easter Sunday was so cold. Does it warm up? Chicago, not today, but by the time we get to Wednesday, at least we'll be in the low 50s. Our average high is 60, Alex. We are not even close to that yet.
Not even, my goodness. Meanwhile, winter in Caribou, Maine. These places are no stranger to snow. But, I mean, now we're getting to kind of ridiculous times in the year.
It's ridiculous. Alex, have you noticed, and maybe you didn't, you're wearing a purple shirt. You're just talking about purple.
Yep.
And purple feels like it's the color this spring. Like, if you walk in stores and you see, like, a massive purple. So, I don't know, the retailers knew that something, you know, with the weather before we did.
They
but purple
have.
Seems to be the color. Also indicates some chill on our weather map.
It certainly does. And that's meaning 20 to even 30 degrees below average in a few spots.
All right, let's go out to Justin Michaels, who is live this morning at the Boston Marathon. Justin, how is it? Talk about what's, you know, the energy like there. I know this is an exciting day for folks in Boston.
It is Patriots Day here in Boston. This is a very important day for the people who live here. And of course, the 30,000 runners, of course, it's a very important day for them.
And Justin, the next time we talk to you, we've got some graphics to showcase like how important temperature is to running. So stick around for that.
Yeah, it should be fun. Yeah. Justin, I understand you're going to be suiting up and getting out of the race here.
He's starting at the finish. He's starting at the finish.
Exactly. I will cover the 0.2 miles. Okay, 0.2, and we're done. They can
Sounds
do the 26.
Good. All right, Justin, we'll check back with you in just a bit. So that all brings us to our question of the day: Are you running, or maybe not so much? Right? What other outdoor activities would you maybe choose? That's part of our whole question for the day. And some of the other answer choices include biking and hiking.
Yeah.
Maybe just point plain old just walking. or something else.
Yeah, we know a lot of you might not choose running, but what is, you know, the sport that gets you into the out there? So we want to know, is it running? Is it hiking or biking? Is it, hiking, walking?
Ah, okay, those are combined.
Or biking. Yeah.
There's
always something else. Let us know.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, the Sierra in California might be the last place.
Here across the Pacific Northwest.
All right, so we'll truly be watching that. All right, how about we get into the app there? We got some events.
Good things for you here as we get through this week. It's a different week because the last 4 weeks have pretty much had 2 or 3 days in a row of severe weather.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Finally breaking that pattern here just a bit. Now, we will be tracking a few systems, but here's how it plays out. This is basically what it looks like for today. We've got a system trying to sneak its way on into the west here for us. Not a whole lot of moisture here in the middle of the country, but we're going to start to see that changing just a bit here as we work our way through the midweek.
Okay, so here comes the moisture return. By the time we get to Wednesday, there'll be high pressure heading to the east. Around that flow, we'll get some southerly winds to bring us moisture back into Texas. That'll also go hand in hand with the instability going up as well, all the way up into eastern Kansas and western Missouri.
Yeah, so that's going to set the stage for some thunderstorm activity here for the mid part of the week. And you'll see that, again, stretching from portions of the Gulf Coast states all the way to the upper Midwest. And then we get northbound, hugging the U.S.-Canadian border. Maybe chilly enough that we have to deal with, well, a little bit more wintry weather.
Now, in terms of severe weather and the chance of storms here, on Wednesday, we'll look at a possible chance. Kansas City, southward through Tulsa, Oklahoma City, Wichita Falls, maybe Dallas, or maybe it's just north of you. But this is different this week. It's not as large of an area that we're watching, but certainly it's April, and that sun energy is strong, so severe weather could expand as we get closer to it.
Absolutely, no doubt. So, Tom, make it out here. This is early on Wednesday morning. Right here in the Heartland, we're dealing with the rain showers as well as storms. So there'll be ongoing storms early in the morning hours, continuing to kind of spread towards the east a bit for your Wednesday afternoon. Notice that southern half kind of dries out a bit. That's that northern extent where we'll carry on that threat for the rain as that pushes its way on off towards the east.
I mean, look, someone in Detroit or Grand Rapids is like, I'm just glad this isn't snow at this point, considering your forecast today, right? But we do get rain by the end of the week, and Thursday, a few showers heading to northern New England and a few showers lifting north again with the next little piece of energy coming into Iowa and into northern Missouri.
All right. So we put it all together here. This is the forecast in terms of rain for tomorrow through Thursday. And most areas here, we're not looking for gargantuan amounts of rain. Most areas looking for less than an inch of rain. There'll be some pockets here and there. We can get a downpour with some of these thunderstorms that get going. Maybe into Missouri and Arkansas where we could see a few spots in the 1 to 2 inch category.
All right. So let's look at your forecast, Dallas, because we talked about you. And I know it's been a stressful last month, really, of active weather. We will see thunderstorms come in Tuesday night. But I think most notably, I mean, they'll be hit or miss. It'll be dry, it'll be warming up, and it'll be windy here over the next several days.
Absolutely. Well, we're just days away now from marking 40 years since beginning our commitment to you.
And we want to thank those who are sharing a few kind words of our 4 decades of covering severe weather, hurricane, snow, and even sunny days. For climate, so.
That's a good point.
Yeah, you got
good
options.
Good day to run today.
Yeah, warming up nicely, but not too hot.
But man, that's a scary situation.
Right. And it's, you know, also, they, of course, did it right with using rope, right?
Yes.
What is it? Throw, row, go is the, like, rule of thumb when it comes to rescuing someone. Throw them something. Try to get them to catch on to that before you actually go out in the water.
So you don't want both of you now having to be rescued.
Yeah. It's cold, you know? The water's cold.
Still. Yeah. All right. Well, we still have cold temperatures to deal with in the northern tier. Meanwhile, farther south, Jen, still hanging on to that threat for a few showers and maybe even some stronger storms.
It was really warm yesterday. We had some heavy rainfall in a few spots. So let's show you what we're going to deal with today. We could see a few thunderstorms, Alex mentioned. The thing today about our weather is it's going to be, I think, pretty isolated. We're not going to be looking for everyone to get into the thunderstorm activity. It's really hanging along the coast from Melbourne and the Space Coast area back down through West Palm and Fort Lauderdale, Miami. That's where we could see some thunderstorms here. We'll also keep an eye on some storms up here across the coastal areas of South Carolina and North Carolina. At Charleston, Myrtle Beach, you've got some chances of seeing that. I mean, you look at all the action, it's mainly out over the water here. So, you know, I don't think there'll be a lot of activity up here across South and North Carolina, but I do think we could get some storms to develop here later on today, and that's what we're going to keep an eye on. We have a lot of rain. I mean, look at Charlotte right now, a really steady rain coming your way for the commute this morning. Raleigh, we've got showers, especially north of town. They've been heavy. All of this is going to go just west of Richmond. That I-64 ride is going to be tough. tough. And Roanoke, yeah, we've got it all. A little snow activity there mixing in with your rain this morning. It's wet snow, but it's still just or chilly rain, either way you want to call it. Hilton Head, a few showers have pushed on through. Your bike this morning, your bike ride there, not that fun, right? Because the showers that have been moving in or out. And then we take it out here just off the coast. I mean, it is not a day to be out in the water here from Wilmington to Moorhead City up towards Cape Hatteras. Look at all of that rain out over the water, and there is lightning with it, another risk that you'll be dealing with. So just stay on shore today there. All right, so let's take a look at what else is coming our way as we see the forecast for today. You know, we've got an area of low pressure that's going to be moving up here through the mid-Atlantic, and that is going to be keeping us unsettled, you know, especially northern parts of Virginia, eastern North Carolina. You can see everything kind of coming together right there. But for everyone else, things are moving through, and you see a few lingering showers do sort of snip us here on the Space Coast, but we're not going to be looking at a ton of activity, just a few isolated storms, which these could be the ones that affect you. I mean, look at West Palm Beach, a few isolated showers, maybe some thunderstorms. We'll keep an eye on this afternoon. Fort Myers, we've got a chance. Everglades City, over, you know, southeastern parts of Florida, there is a chance into this evening. Again, it's isolated, but it's possibly going to bring you some rain at your commute. Then we go up to the cool side of things. Alex, what's it like in Boston?
Oh, right.
Women were not allowed to run. And I'm like, right. I'm not that much older than that.
It's just mind-boggling thinking that just 50 years ago, women were not, I can't even fathom that.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you for being there today.
They weren't allowed, really, in fact. Oh, well, and also the history of women running in this, there were a few years before 1972 where women...
Yes, indeed.
Yes,
running
yes.
with pride. Love it. Thank you, Justin. And I think it's going to be a fast course, Alex, because the temperatures that we have are optimal, as you will see, for marathon running.
I mean, look at that. I mean, lots of sunshine out there. We got clear skies. Now the clouds start to come in a little bit later, and it does get a bit breezy for that second part of the day, but overall... I mean, you really can't ask for a better forecast.
The ones at the end are going to deal with that wind, so that's going to be a factor. It'll be a headwind, too, another factor. But temperatures, you know, we're going to be really chill across the mid-Atlantic today. And in southern New England, we're not that far from average, a little below, and that might be perfect because for elite runners, you generate twice the body heat compared to average runners. And 50 to 75% of them say the best times come in at 45.9 degrees, which is like what we're at.
Exactly right there. The top 25 is about 42 degrees or so. And then that top 1% of runners, those are the ones that, you know, finish fairly quickly, 38.9. So actually going to be a little bit warmer for those top 1%.
But for most runners, today's going to be optimal. We're sitting right at 46 degrees right now. That's perfect, right? I mean, if you round up, that's exactly where we are. No wind gusts, light wind coming in from the north. Visibility, beautiful. You saw the blue sky there. So.
Yeah, this is great. Absolutely. So again, there's that forecast, your force, the sun. But watch those winds start to kick up a little
bit. All right, so let's talk about the wind. Winds are going to be gusting 15 to 20 miles per hour. I think we'll see the wind change a little more to the east as we go through the day. So that east wind, the clouds are also going to be on the increase, and it will also create a wind chill factor.
Yeah, so feeling more like the low 40s for you in the city, at least right now. But when it comes to the wind, 10 mile per hour wind here for us, a headwind, that's going to reduce your time by about 12 seconds per mile.
Now, if you have a tailwind, that would improve your time by 6 seconds per mile, but we just don't have that today, so sorry. Drafting can reduce up to 80% of performance decline due to headwind, so just like on biking, drafting works with running too.
Absolutely. All right, so good times, of course, following, including the Earth Day Family Night Hike. Speaking of getting out and hiking and walking, doing that in Roswell, Georgia, at the Chattahoochee Nature Center here for us. This will be on Friday evening.
This is going to be great. Now, North Day is actually Thursday, but events are happening before, on, and after. And if you're going to the Friday night hike, temps are going to be in the upper 70s and should stay mild through your hike. It's not going to drop off real quickly.
Right.
So looking good.
Not bad at all. How about we head down into Florida for the Pensacola Earth Day Festival here. That'll be taking place at Bayview Park. This is going to be on the 23rd, basically morning through the afternoon. And another nice looking forecast. Again, not too hot, not cool, no rain.
The weather like this brings more people out, right? You're sort of looking for something to do on a day like this. We've got ideas. How about go to Yosemite National Park for their Earth Day Festival? Might be a few showers, but then again.
Exactly. Wow, yeah. Always fun times at the ballpark unless hailstones are coming down.
Yeah, that doesn't happen that often.
I was going to say, that's not something I've actually seen.
And it's got to be really early season games or maybe late season games.
Maybe.
But, you know, early season.
Yeah, it's good. This would be the time if it's going to happen.
All right, everyone. Well, welcome back. And it is Monday, America's Morning Headquarters, getting you through the mid-morning hours, helping you plan for the big events ahead this week.
Thanks so much for staying with us here as we roll on through this Monday. Hope you had a good Easter weekend. Kicking things off here on this Monday, finally getting the Boston Marathon here when it's rightfully supposed to happen here in Boston here for an update on how things are getting going there. Perfect weather conditions, though, right now.
For runners especially, and we'll talk about just how perfect coming up as well. Want to take you into a snapshot for the weather today, and we do.
About Phoenix, 97 degrees there for the day.
All right. Well, you ready to run?
Not in Phoenix.
That's true. Or the marathon either, Alex. I don't think. Well, you, I hope you're ready to run. You can lace up your shoes, get ready.
Mother Nature setting up a battle royale. It is the clash of the seasons, the threat of hazardous hail, damaging winds, and strong tornadoes for the fourth straight week. That versus Winter Storm Silas getting ready to plaster the northern plains, unleashing possibly blizzard conditions. By the way, blizzard conditions that could last for days. And the snow is expected to pile up. We are talking 3 feet of flakes to go along with the whipping winds, and that could make travel downright dangerous. And more than 45 million people are bracing for severe storms, stretching from southern Minnesota to Texas. We're timing it all out to keep you safe. Really, over the next couple of days, we're going to have to be dealing with this stuff. This is America's Morning Headquarters. I'm meteorologist Stephanie Abrams alongside meteorologist Jim Cantore and Jordan Steele. And I'll tell you what, Jordan, we got to take a breath. There's a lot to break down, but don't you worry at home. We're going to break it down, you know, state by state, system by system for you, because it's a lot to take in, Jordan.
It is, and you know the problem already is we've had some
atmosphere. Essentially, you've got a big trough in the atmosphere. That is still digging in. This thing is going to turn more negatively tilted tomorrow, and that means your winds are going to really accelerate as we head into our Wednesday time frame. Today, we have enough. We definitely have enough with the upper level winds. We have enough of that low level jet coming in that's going to cause some problems. So here we go with that low level jet. There's good shear. Jim was talking about that dry line, warm, moist ahead of it, warm, dry behind it. And as we go through the day, watch out for some bigger discrete cells to develop. Now, here's the thing. The biggest amount of energy is still a bit west. Everything really kind of swings around as we head into tomorrow. But again, there's enough. It is not exactly lined up, but it is enough lined up that we still have that threat Torcon values of 5. And when you have a Torcon value of 5, that means you could have tornadoes, EF2 possibility. Hail could be a big deal with this. You know, we were talking about that cap. Everything is kind of just has a lid on it, and we have enough instability. Again, it's not off the charts, but we have enough, and this is why you can't let your guard down. We could see some of those discrete cells ahead of our line, and this is just the beginning of a two-day, you know, stormy weather for us here from the northern plains all the way down into the southern plains as everything really sweeps around as we head into our Wednesday, Jordan.
Yeah, so let's pick up the conversation there.
Minot, Grand Forks.
Yeah.
How long we go so in blizzard.
It's interesting you're saying
for
that.
Some of these areas.
Because I was going to pick that up by saying all this wind is really going to last until Friday. It's
right.
Not until Saturday
you're
when
right.
that
after the snow
when that 1042 or whatever high drops down mm-hmm. that we're going to get relief from it. So let's talk about blizzards and what you need exactly to have a blizzard. And if you don't get a blizzard, just having these screaming winds of 40, 50 miles an hour for a week is pretty brutal. But we do have blizzard warnings here. And here we could see winds 50 miles an hour. We could see 12, 24 inches of snow for us when all is said and done. By the way, places like Bismarck in April, we see like 4.6 inches of snow. And Bismarck, by the way, is 13 inches below average. So are we going to wipe out our deficit with this one system? We could, but how much snow is actually going to get to the ground with all the wind that's blowing? Let's have a look at our blizzard warnings for April. We're just going back to 2005, okay? There's Aberdeen, Billings. You'd go see the list. We see 4, 5, 6 blizzard warnings if you go back to 2005. That's it. You don't get a lot of blizzard warnings in April. The last time we had them here really was in 2019, so it's been a few years. What constitutes a blizzard? 35 mile an hour winds, quarter of visibility or less, but that has to be for a 3-hour duration. So are we going to get that? Look at our winds here. They're already gusting 40 miles an hour. The snow's already starting to come down. But, Jim, will we get it for 3 hours? I think absolutely in some places we will get it for 3 hours.
Some of these areas, I think.
As we head into our Friday, Coachella, by the way, starting a big, huge music festival in Indio, California. And don't forget, as we head into our Friday night, we get into Passover, and then we have Easter. Is a lot going on, and then we have Tax Monday as well. So there is a big weekend for us on Saturday in the Midwest and back towards the plains. Things will be a lot quieter. Sunday, we see a little bit of active weather, but look at New York, 52, as if it's touching the ground. So let's talk about that threat as we head over the next couple of days. Essentially, we've got a big trough here in the west, our cold pocket of air coming in. We have our jet stream that's going to be streaming across. We have that southerly flow that's going to be bringing up the warm, moist air and those stronger winds as well. Our trough is still digging in. All right, so that's still digging in. As we head into Wednesday, our trough is going to look more like this, and that's really going to have right up through the center of the country, we're going to have a screaming jet stream coming right up as we get more of a negatively tilted trough. For severe weather, you look for that trough to kind of tilt negatively to see things ramp up. Today, we have enough of it. So the ingredients are there. We have enough to get the storms from Austin to Dallas. And I'm going to need you guys to click me through here because I'm still on the lab clicker. I did not change that out. Thank you. Happens all the time. Here's our Torcon values. They're 3 as we look into places like Texas, Arkansas, Louisiana, and Dallas. Hail is going to be a big deal when you have some colder air. Aloft, you could get that colder air through the whole column to help support that bigger hail getting all the way down to the ground. And look at our dew point temperatures into the 60s and 70s. Of course, they're going to be really high throughout the morning hours there, but this is going to help fuel those storms as we head through the day today and some already popping off, Jim, here into places like Tennessee.
Yeah, so Stephanie just showed you the air mass, which is already established.
Yes.
All right, I got a little work to do in my area that I'm going to cover.
You going north?
I'm going north.
Yeah, you got
so
a little
the dew points
do.
This morning.
It's not really until Saturday when that high pressure drops right
when
down.
Right, when we kind of get a chance
totally,
to melt some of this stuff.
I have a bone to pick with you.
What do you got?
Did you say blizzard-like?
I don't know. I may have. I don't remember. After I finished saying something.
No, it was triple blizzard.
Oh, right.
Triple blizzard.
No such thing as it's either like a blizzard. It's a near blizzard. I can't believe.
A blizzard.
Of all
it is
people.
A blizzard.
That too.
There's no exactly. question this is going to be a blizzard.
I'm with you.
All right. So what did I do wrong?
No, you said blizzard.
I said blizzard-like.
You said blizzard-like, which I feel like is so like, the
wow.
Jim Cantore said blizzard-like.
I'm going to have, so what do I got? 50 lashes with a wet noodle coming up here after the show or before we get out of this break?
All right, let's take you here out the door and show you the severe weather that we're going to see as we head into tomorrow. We are going to see basically our trough dig around. That means you're going to have a jet stream coming up. We got low-level winds. Oh, wow. Okay, low-level winds. I literally just, that is skin. I just cut myself on the monitors. Note to self, guys, don't go near to the monitors there. We'll figure that out in the break. Severe weather here from the Great Lakes all the way down to the Gulf Coast. We have this huge system that's going to be moving east, moisture coming all the way up. And the question is, how far north does that warm front get? That's how far we're going to see some of the storms. So you can get some storms elevated to the north of that. But man, we have got some big cold air coming in to help support not only the snow, but also that severe weather, because you get that cold pocket aloft ahead of that warm, unstable air, and that causes things to pop off here. So tomorrow, we do have that possibility of hail, an inch or more. That's what makes it severe. And then some of us could see 2-inch or greater hail, just for an idea. Golf ball size hail is 1 3/4, and you certainly get dents on your car. You could get it on your roof as well with that big time hail coming in. And then, of course, the ingredients. There's that southerly surface wind. You get also, as you go up in the atmosphere, you get shear because our winds are going to be changing direction with height. So tornadoes are certainly a possibility, not only today, but also tomorrow.